One of the questions we see most often surrounding AMC stock is, will everybody be able to sell their shares during the short squeeze? And it's almost a two-parter. They wonder if they're going to be able to book their profits, for one reason being, if the price goes up to $100,000 or $500,000 during the short squeeze, there's not even that much money in the world. How is everybody going to bring in that kind of cash? And it's a legitimate concern, right? And the next one is, now Clay, you say there's no synthetic shares out there. Guys, I don't say there's zero synthetic shares out there, right? Synthetic shares are derived from FTDs. We know that FTDs exist. Anyway, different subject. You say there's only roughly 90 million, maybe 100 million short shares out there. How could everybody possibly benefit from the short squeeze? So that's exactly what we're going to talk about in this video. And of course, if it sounds like something you're interested in, let's get started. What's up, everybody? I'm Clay. I'm here to make 2021 the best year ever. If you haven't clicked that subscribe button, make sure to subscribe to the channel. Join us. Become a bro. We are here every single day, and we are growing our portfolios together. All right, guys, it's a legitimate concern. We've been here for months now. Whether you joined us in June, whether you're thinking about joining us now, or whether you've been in since January, it's a concern on a lot of people's minds on whether or not we're going to be able to sell our shares during the short squeeze. Will everybody profit off of this AMC stock short squeeze or not? Well, okay, guys, I understand that the concern's there, and I don't know if we're just trying to be, like, you know, socially correct and hope that everybody benefits off of it or whatever the thought is. The two main concerns that people have is, one, are there going to be enough short shares out there to cover everybody? There's 500 million shares outstanding, and there's only roughly 100 million short shares that exist. So that's one of the concerns. The other one is, if the price goes so high, where's this money going to come from? So let's address that one first, right? It's not going to be easy. And I'm not going to sit here and advocate that we're going to see $100,000 a share or $500,000 a share or anything like that. Is it possible? Absolutely. But it's only possible. It's only possible if we do not sell the shares back to the hedge funds before we reach that point. Guys, I've talked about the temptation people are going to see along the way. As soon as people see more money than they've ever seen in their entire life, trust me when I tell you, they're going to be tempted. So for illustration purposes in this video, let's just assume, okay, this is an assumption. This is not saying we're going to reach 100,000 or 500,000 or whatever. Let's just assume that everybody overcomes their temptation and we hold out. Okay, we start to see $10,000, $50,000, $100,000, $500,000 per share. How's that going to look? And you might say, well, if everybody waits out to $500,000, how's this going to play out? There's not that much money. Guys, not everybody is going to sell at the peak, okay? That in wherever that peak comes, okay? Not everybody is going to sell at the peak. That's why it's a peak. You might only have one or two transactions come across at the absolute peak of the short squeeze. That is why I stress so much in my videos and in my live streams that you've got a better chance of hitting the lottery than you do timing the actual peak of the AMC stock short squeeze. So please do not beat yourself up by thinking that, well, I missed out on, I don't know, an extra 10%, an extra 100%, even an extra 1,000% during this short squeeze. Please do not beat yourself up over the fact that you did not time the peak perfectly, because only one or two people are going to do that. And we know there's 4.1 million shareholders at this point, possibly more or less right now. We're talking about the last, you know, count we did, but there's a lot of people holding and only one or two may hit the top of the peak. That's why the peak, guys. That's why it's the peak, guys. You know, they people are buying and they're selling, they're buying and they're selling, and then all of a sudden, they're not buying anymore, right? The price goes back down. They're not buying anymore. So this transaction up here, it's going to be the last one that they're buying at. So please keep that in mind. So, yeah, when And just for illustration, it's hard for me to say, right? AMC stock going to $500,000 a share, right? But let's just say there is somebody who gets that, and maybe they've got 10 shares of AMC that are sold at $500,000, okay? That's not going to break the global financial system watching AMC go to that price, and then they have to fill 5, 10 shares at that order, and then watch it drop back down in price. So that's one of the rationales behind the fact that, yes, we could reach these prices, but not everybody gets filled at the peak. Okay, that's the answer to that one, is that not everybody is going to take advantage of the absolute maximum. Now, the next one, and this is perhaps one of the reasons that everybody has this need to believe in synthetics, that everybody has this need to believe in the manipulation and corruption and naked shares that exist out there. But look, guys, I understand that everybody wants paid. Everybody will get paid if you sell your shares during the AMC stock short squeeze. We do not need the billions of synthetics. We do not need hundreds of millions of synthetics. Sure, it would be nice if they exist, because that just means more buying pressure during the squeeze. That means that there's more shares out there that hedge funds have to buy, right? But I'm not even going down that route. Let's say there's 100 million short shares that they have to cover. If you think for 1 minute that the volume, the peak volume during AMC stock short squeeze is going to be 100 million, I don't know if you've watched the stock trade in the past. I don't know if you have. Look at June. We had just rising up to the peak in June. You're talking about numbers like 100 million, 300 million, 600 million, 750 million shares being traded in 1 day, okay? And they only covered a net 17 million short shares during that time. What does that tell you? That tells you that the high frequency traders and the day traders absolutely flock to that volatility, okay? You could have sold the entire float over twice in the same day, just during the June run-up. Now imagine if the stock price is soaring to 500, 1,000, 5,000, 10,000. Imagine when the stock price soars that much, how many day traders and how many high-frequency traders are going to flock to that volatility. And here's one thing. And the FOMO, I forgot about the FOMO buyers. Remember those guys who are going to say, oh, I'm going to miss out on the short squeeze. I need to get in at $200 a share because I can ride it to $1,000 a share, right? Remember those guys that are going to jump on too. And here's the rule that you have to remember right now. You're in AMC stock already. These guys, these day traders, they understand the risk. They understand the volatility that the stock can go back down. So do not care if they get left holding a bag, okay? These FOMO buyers don't care if they get left holding a bag. They're waiting out for a reason. If they think that they can time this thing perfectly, that's the risk that they're willing to take. They're willing to take the risk that they got in too late. It does not matter if they end up holding the bag on this thing, because you're in this, you're in AMC for one reason and one reason only. That is the stock squeeze. That is the short squeeze on AMC. And it's not, guys, I don't, like, there's no feelings in this. You're not supposed to be emotional when it comes to the stock market. So if other people end up holding the bag, They're providing those shares. They're providing that liquidity for you to sell your shares during the stock squeeze. So yes, hedge funds will have to buy 100 million shares. But please do not think for 1 minute that the volume is going to peak out at 100 million shares during the squeeze. There will absolutely be opportunity for you and I to sell our shares multiple times over. So it's not even a question of concern at this point. And I hope this just eases the minds of a few people out there who were wondering if and how you're going to be able to sell your shares during the AMC stock short squeeze if there's only 100 short shares out there, or 100 million short shares out there, and if the prices go as absolutely high as a lot of people think they're going to go. Now, if that button is still red right there, make sure to subscribe to the channel. Join us. Become a bro. We are here every single day, and we are growing our portfolios together. And I want to know down in the comments below if you are holding until the absolute end, if these concerns aren't even a concern for you, if you're not worried about getting out during the short squeeze, if you already have your price in mind, if you are mentally prepared to watch AMC go to the absolute moon. Guys, inspire us to be better holders down there. Inspire us to have those diamond hands and inspire us to make as much money as possible during the AMC stock short squeeze. And there's a lot of links down in the description, so make sure to check each and every one of those out. Claybro883 on Twitter and Instagram if you want to follow me there. And I'm pretty sure that's it, guys. So until the next time, I hope that each and every one of you have an awesome day.